गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. इन द सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स ऑफ रिग्रेशन एनालिसिस ऑफ एमएससी सेकेंड ईयर पेपर, द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज मल्टीपल लीनियर रिग्रेशन एंड फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ लेक्चर ऑफ रेसिडुअल. सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी विल सी टू टाइप्स ऑफ रेसिडुअल्स. द फर्स्ट इज स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड रेसिडुअल एंड सेकेंड वन इज स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड रेसिडुअल. टुडे लेट वी सी व्हाट इज द प्रेस रेसिडुअल. सो प्रेस रेसिडुअल मीन्स प्रिडिक्शन एरर सम ऑफ square and hence P-R-E-S-S. P-R, we have first letters of prediction, that is P-R-E-S-S. So prediction error sum of squares method. Okay. So if we delete the ith observation, fit the regression model to the remaining n minus 1 observation. Over here the procedure is we are delete the ith observation, fit the regression model to the remaining n minus 1 observations and calculate predicted value corresponding to deleted observation. And we can calculate the predicted value for the corresponding deleted observation, that is the ith observation. Okay. The corresponding prediction error is E of I is equal to yi minus yi hat I. Okay, so that is my prediction error for ith observation by deleting that particular observation, and we can calculate the prediction value by using remaining n minus 1 observation. Okay. So the prediction error calculation is repeated for each observation. So I varying from 1 to n. So we can repeat this procedure n times. So these prediction errors is called as press residuals or deleted residuals. Since we can delete the observation, it is also called as deleted residuals. So press means prediction error sum of squares. Okay. If it would be seen that calculating the press residuals requires fitting n different regression equations. So fitting n different regression equation, that is most important part in the press residual, because since we are calculating each time we can delete the ith observation, hence over here the n different regression equations are fitted. The press residual is press is equal to EI divided by 1 minus HII, I varying from 1 to up to N. Residual associated with points for which HII is large will have large press. So over here, residual associated with points for which HII is large will have large press. So if HII is large, obviously this quantity is small, and since this quantity is small, the value is large. These points will generally be high influence points. So these are the points with high influence point, means over there we can get the outliers. Okay. Finally, the variance of ith residual is variance of EI is equal to, over here variance of EI is equal to variance of EI divided by 1 minus HII, that is we replace the value of E of I. So that is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus HII square, and the variance of EI is sigma square 1 minus HII. Hence the value is sigma square divided by 1 minus HII. So that standardized press residual is EI divided by square root of variance of EI, which is equal to EI divided by 1 minus HII divided by square root of sigma square upon 1 minus HII, which is equal to EI divided by square root of sigma square 1 minus HII. So if we replace estimate of sigma square as MRSS, then it is just the standardized residual. So over here, if we replace estimate of sigma square, so estimate of sigma square is replaced as MRSS, then it is a standardized residual. Okay. Another approach would be used to estimate sigma square based on data with ith observation removed. That means we can find the sigma square by deleting the ith observation. So denote the estimate of sigma square so obtained S square I. Hence S square I is N minus P M R S S minus EI square divided by 1 minus HII divided by N minus P minus 1. Okay, so that is the value which we used to estimate the value of sigma square. Hence extremely standardized residual usually which is the extremely standardized residual usually called R student is given by Ti is equal to Ei divided by square root of S square I into bracket 1 minus Hi. That is, over here we can replace the value of sigma square as S square I, that is the estimate of sigma square. So I varying from 1 to n. This is the trace residual for finding the or for detecting the outliers. Now there are residual plots which we use to plot the residual. So graphical analysis of residual is a very effective way to investigate the adequacy of fit of the regression model and to check the underlying observation. So all these methods are actually we can use it whether our model is inadequate or not, or whether they possesses all the assumptions or not. It is good idea to plot the original residual and one or more of the scalar residual. That is, original residuals we have EI, and again the scalar residuals means the standardized or trace residual. Okay, we usually prefer to plot standardized residuals because they have constant variance, and variance is almost equal to 1. Okay, normal. So first residual plot is normal probability plot. A very simple method of checking the normality assumption is to construct normal probability plot of residual. So this is the very simplest method for checking whether the our normality assumption is followed or not. This graph is designed so that the cumulative normal distribution will plot as a straight line. Cumulative normal distribution will be plot as a straight line, ranked in increasing order if we plot EI against cumulative probabilities. These are the ranked, be the residuals ranked in increasing order if we plot EI against cumulative probabilities. So over here PI, which are the probabilities which we plot, is equal to I minus half divided by N. And since and obviously we know that I is equal to 1 up to N. On a normal probability plot, resulting points should be lie approximately on straight line. The straight line usually determined visually with emphasis on the central values rather than extremes. So we can plot the probability values and it results a straight line. And straight line usually we can visualize, usually we can visualize it, but in some cases we cannot observe the extreme values. The substantial departure from straight line indicates that the distribution is not normal. So sometimes normal probability plots are constructed by plotting ranked residuals EI against the expected normal value, and the expected normal value can be calculated by using phi inverse I minus half divided by N, that is PI. Okay, where phi denotes the standard normal cumulative distribution. This follows fact that expectation of EI approximately follows phi inverse of I minus half divided by N. Okay, so that is the expected value of your EI. Okay, so the normal probability plot looks in this manner. So first plot is my ideal plot, which indicates that the normality assumption is followed by the data set. So we can get a straight line passing through points. So over here we can plot EI and probability. So again the second plot with EI and probability, but this is heavy tailed, and since we over here also we can draw a straight line, but we can get a heavy tailed values below the straight line, and hence these type of graphs are observed while the distribution of the data set is Cauchy distribution. Now over here we can get a straight line, but over here also the data sets are lie in a light tailed values, and the light tailed values are observed in the Laplace distribution. Okay, and again in next case, that is the fourth case, we get a values which are scattered in zigzag manner, and this is because of positively skewed data set. And in the negatively skewed data set, we get this order, or we get the, since in positively skewed the values are above the line, and in the negatively skewed the values are below the straight line. Okay, and to solve this problem, that is to solve this normality problem, we prefer the log normal transformation. Usually about 20 points are required to produce normal probability plots are stable enough to easily interpreted. They are subjective in nature. That is, if we have 20 points, then we can visualize whether the normality assumption is followed by the data set or not. Okay. So in today's lecture, we will see what is stress residual and then the regression plot. From the regression plot, we only see the normal probability plot. Thank you.